Joan Didion is quite extraordinary.
And unexpected.
Joan's writing would grab the reader.
What a fresh voice.
Joan Didion was born on December 5th, 1934, in Sacramento, California, to Frank Reese Didion and Eugene Didion. Her father was an officer in the Army Air Corps during World War I, so she was constantly moving and didn't go to school regularly. However, despite their constant relocations, they did move back to Sacramento in 1943. After her childhood years, Didion attended Berkeley, where she got a degree in English. One of her most notable accomplishments was winning an essay contest sponsored by Vogue magazine. The prize was a research assistant job for the magazine, and she worked there for more than 10 years.
Work. Didion's professional career took off at age 20 when, as a senior at UC Berkeley, she won an essay contest sponsored by Vogue. She packed up and moved to New York City, starting at the magazine as a research assistant and rising to the rank of associate editor. She wrote lifestyle pieces by day and penned her first book, Run River, by night.
After her book was published, she met John Gregory Dunne, another writer, and the two married a year later. From New York, the two moved to Los Angeles and adopted their daughter, Quintana Roo.
And together would become sought-after script doctors, collaborating on screenplays including Up Close and Personal, starring Robert Redford and Michelle Pfeiffer, A Star is Born, starring Barbara Streisand, and an adaptation of Didion's own novel, Play It As It Lay.
Although later, things took a turn for the worst when Dunne passed away in 2003 of a heart attack, and then Quintana in 2005 to acute pancreatitis. As hard as it was, Didion wrote about her loss in her books The Year of Magical Thinking and Blue Nights, to which both were rewarded for masterful journalism.
Write about grief itself, the difference between grief as we imagine it and grief as it really is. What's the difference?
Well, the one difference that struck me was that we generally think of grief when we're not in the middle of experiencing it. We think of it as a progressive thing, that it progresses, you get better every day, right? But it goes up and down, and it goes in waves, which is something everybody mentions. You know, suddenly you're doubled over by it. You might have been doing very well for several days, and you're just walking down the street and suddenly you're bent over.
Didion's writing style was unconventional in her time, which caught her audience's attention. She mainly wrote in the style of new journalism, which communicated facts through narrative stories and literary devices. This style is also known as creative nonfiction. She became a symbol of mass culture, and her fans worshipped her.
She's writing about all sorts of disorder.
I've always found that if I examine something, it's less scary.
She wanted to go there. She wanted to get in on that.
One of Didion's most notable influencers is Ernest Hemingway. It is him who taught her through his writing the way sentences could work within a piece. She believes that the media is what tells us how to live. And through nonfiction writing, she displays the element of discovery about the way of life.
During the blue nights, you think the end of day will never come. As the blue nights draw to a close, and they will and they do, you experience an actual chill, an apprehension of illness at the moment you notice. The blue light is going, the days are already shorter, the summer is gone. This book is called Blue Nights because at the time I began it, I found my mind turning increasingly to illness, to the end of promise, to the dwindling of the days, the inevitability of the fading, the dying of the brightness. Blue nights are the opposite of the dying of the brightness, but they are also its warning.
Didion is notable for her many awards, including the American Academy of Arts and Letters Gold Medal in Criticism, as well as the Belles Letters in 2005. Her work continues to leave a legacy on her readers, and hopefully for more years to come.
Changed my perceptions in a way that you certainly hadn't expected.
Joan Didion rightly has earned distinction as one of the most celebrated American writers of her generation.
I didn't plan it that way.
Which is very like life itself.